Welcome to the Control-M Workload Automation Monitoring Jobs module. We recommend that you watch the Control-M Workload Automation overview before starting this module. In this module, you will walk through some basic scenarios for monitoring jobs in Control-M. The monitoring domain of Control-M Workload Automation enables you to view and identify errors that occur during job execution, analyze and find the root cause of a problem, and take corrective action. To better understand which jobs are monitored, you should be familiar with the job lifecycle. Job processing definitions are stored in the Job Definitions database. Once a day, the New Day procedure evaluates each job scheduling criteria and determines whether it should be run on that day. If so, the job is ordered and an instance of the job is created and placed in the active jobs environment. Jobs can also be ordered manually. Jobs run when their prerequisites are met. The monitoring domain tells you the status of the active jobs and lets you manage them. The active jobs environment includes jobs that are waiting to be executed, jobs that are currently running, and jobs that have completed processing. In the monitoring domain, the status of each job is indicated by a color and an icon. Let's look at four possible job statuses. A waiting condition status is gray and indicates jobs waiting to be submitted. Sometimes, a job with a waiting status could indicate a problem with preceding jobs. The executing status is yellow and indicates that a job is running. The ended OK status is green and indicates that a job has executed successfully. The ended not OK status is red. This indicates that a job did not successfully complete its processing. In this module, you will learn how to use viewpoints and alerts to view and identify problems, and how to use various tools to analyze and fix problems. You will also learn how to modify an active job according to a special request. Now you will learn how to monitor active job flows using a viewpoint. Let's open the Monitoring Domain's Home tab. Click the Monitoring Domain icon. Viewpoints display in real time the execution status of the active jobs environment. Control-M provides a set of predefined viewpoints. You can define other viewpoints by specifying filtering and grouping parameters. Let's start by looking at the All Jobs viewpoint. Click All Jobs. In the All Jobs viewpoint, you see the top-level object, the Control-M server. The color of the Control-M server object is the same as the color of the job that requires the most attention. To see the jobs, let's click Expand All. As we mentioned earlier, the status of each job is represented by its color and icon. Green jobs completed successfully. Red jobs completed with errors. Yellow jobs are currently executing. And gray jobs are waiting to be run. You can see that there are other statuses, such as pink for a job that needs confirmation before running. In the viewpoint, you can quickly identify jobs that need attention by using a few methods. You can click a Control-M server object. This displays a pie chart summarizing job statuses and gives you an overall picture of the state of your jobs. Another method is expanding the tree view and looking for red folders. An additional way to identify problematic jobs is by dragging the network overview bar on top of red areas. Using the viewpoint, we have identified that the job backup inventory list has ended not okay. The next step is to determine the cause of the problem. When you select a job, the job's properties and other related information appears on the right side of the screen. This information includes not only a summary of the job definition, but also data that was produced during the job's execution, such as the log and output. Click the Log tab. If you look at this job's log, you will see that the script file could not be found. A closer look reveals that there is a typo in the script name. Now that we have identified the problem, it is time to take action. Actions on jobs are initiated from their right-click menus. In this example, we will edit the name of the script. The script name is part of the job's properties. To change it, choose Properties from the menu and click Modify Job. In the File Name field, let's change the script's name. Changes made in the monitoring domain are only applied to the instance of the job in the Active Jobs environment and do not affect its definition in the Job Definitions database. We have finished changing the file name and can save the changes by clicking Save. Let's rerun the job. The status turns yellow as the job is executed. This time it has ended without errors, so the job's color is green and its icon has changed to a check mark. To confirm that the job has run as expected, we can look at the job's log or output. The log contains Control-M messages about the job's execution. The output contains messages produced by the program or script that the job is running. Here we can see a message indicating that the backup has completed successfully. You have learned to use viewpoints to view and identify errors. Now you will learn how to use alerts to view and identify errors. To open alerts, you can click the Alerts button at the top of the screen, or click the Alerts icon on the right side of the screen. Click the Alerts button. An alert is a message that tells you that a job has a problem or an exception has occurred. When you click an alert, you can see the alert's details on the right side of the screen. To find out more information about the job that generated this alert, locate the job by right-clicking the alert and selecting Locate Job. A viewpoint opens with a problematic job selected, and the job's details appear on the right side of the screen. To analyze the cause of the error, click the Output tab. The job's output indicates that an invoice cannot be found. Let's look at the actual script to see how it searches for the invoice. You can see that the script is looking for the invoice in the wrong location. You can edit the script to correct the location of the invoice. Click the Edit button. Now that we have edited the script, we can rerun it. And verify that its status is now OK. Next, we will discuss a scenario where you receive a request to change the schedule of a job that is in the Active Jobs environment. Laura from the distribution department called. She asked that for today only, the shipment report must be generated earlier than usual. How can you quickly locate the job that controls the report generation? Let's click the Find button and enter Report in the Find toolbar. Now click the Find icon to initiate the search. A list of jobs that match the search criteria appears on the bottom of the screen. You can click a job name to select it. You can see the job's information on the right side of the screen. Let's click the Waiting Info tab. Here we can see that the job is scheduled to run at 7 p.m. The action that we want to take is to change the job's scheduling definition so that it will run now. Scheduling is part of the job's properties. To modify the properties, we will right-click the job and select Properties. Let's click Modify Job and then Scheduling. We will change the From Time field. And click Save. The job will now run according to the newly defined time setting. The job is now running. Its status has changed. Another way to immediately run a job is to select the Run Now option from a job's right-click menu. Let's summarize what you have learned in this module. The first step in a typical monitoring task is to view and identify issues. You can do this by using Viewpoints and the Alert screen. Once you have identified a problematic job, you can select the job. By selecting the job, you can view detailed information about the job on the right side of the screen. This information includes log, output, the actual script that is run, waiting information, documentation, and more. If a job flow encounters a problem, you can correct the problem by selecting actions from a job's right-click menu. It contains actions such as hold, free, rerun, and modify job. The job's properties are accessed from the right-click menu as well. You can modify the properties if you find that they were not configured correctly. Another tool that is available for correcting an error is to modify the script that the job runs. This is done using the Script tab on the right side of the screen. You have learned that with a few simple steps, you can monitor the state of your job flow, identify causes of problems, and take corrective actions. We hope it gave you a starting point for exploring additional features and functionalities of the monitoring domain. You have now completed the Monitoring Jobs module. Thank you for viewing this module.